Well, hello everyone, and welcome to Dvorak State Park in northern Idaho on a lovely lake, which I think is called Freeman Creek Lake. I'm not sure about that, but it's supposedly full of lake trout, which means that I won't catch any from the shore. But I've seen quite a few boats here geared up and ready to go for that adventure. This is a family state park within spitting distance of Spokane, Washington, so it's quite full up here on the 4th of July weekend. This is Thursday, July 2nd, I think. So the crowds haven't quite yet descended, but I managed to get one little tent site in an absolutely beautiful spot here, and it is a gorgeous lake, so I'm very happy to be here. I came through Washington today. You'll see some of the footage of the road trip follows the Snake River, and actually the route taken by Lewis and Clark, the American explorers who really opened up the West back in the 19th century. And I came through Washington, then into Idaho. And tomorrow I expect I'll be in Montana, although it being the 4th of July weekend, I'm not entirely sure where I'll stay, but hopefully there'll be a site for me at the National Forest in Montana. So to look at the map from this place east, it's just a whole lot of blank space, a lot of forests and mountains. So I have to go pretty far north to get to a road that I can take through Montana. So I think you'll see some pretty country. I wanted to tell you a story about last night. After all that heat, I finally got a lovely light rain shower, and it's cooled off. It's a cold snap here in Idaho. It was only 99 today, and but it was lovely last night up in the mountains when the rains came. And kudos again to this gear top tent that I have really put through the mill since I set out 2 months ago. You know, most tents aren't used 2 months straight, and this one I think cost me $60 on Amazon, and it's been a real winner. So if you need a tent, by all means, I recommend that one. But I was lying in the tent, you know, as the rains came sort of close to midnight last night, and thinking, you know, just really how perfect that was. You know, I was in a beautiful spot, in good health, or as in, you know, good a health as any 63-year-old can hope for, and you know, no real worries in my life. And I thought that this is really what as close to perfection as I think we can hope for in this life. And you know, I reached for my phone to put on some music that, to me, represents the most perfect piece of music on earth, just to score that moment for myself. And it was a section of Beethoven's Seventh Symphony. I think it's the Allegretto section that begins about 13 minutes in, if you happen to have a recording of Beethoven's Seventh. But, you know, that song makes me weep. Just the talent that Beethoven had, and the memories of that song too. I spent just a delightful afternoon with Jill in Paris, maybe 5 years ago, just lying there listening to Beethoven's Seventh in that particular section, the Allegretto, and it's just perfection. It's just so lovely. And so I thought I would score today's road trip to that. And when I was fiddling with it, I stopped for my obligatory carton of whole milk this morning at a gas station in Oregon. And I just, you know, listening to another Beethoven piece, which is Ode to Joy, the tears are just running down my cheeks, and I'm sure the people at the gas station thought, here's an unfortunate, mentally ill older gentleman who's, you know, at the end of his rope or something. But I don't know what it is about that song. You know, when you realize that Beethoven was deaf, he was deaf so much of the time he was composing, and yet he produced this just magic in music. And you know, I often say to people that Beethoven is the absolute hands-down refutation of atheism. Because while I suppose people might say there's every chance that I evolved from a bit of pond scum, you don't get to Beethoven from pond scum. You don't get to that by chance, and you don't get to it in a man who is deaf. He has to be hearing the music of heaven, and I think that Ode to Joy in particular, if there is a Morse code of salvation, it's in Ode to Joy. So those were my thoughts last night. I hope they're of interest to you, and I hope you enjoy today's road trip. I hope to see you tomorrow in Montana. So until then, God bless you, and thank you for following my journey.
Thank you.